Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am going to be sharing with you a video on what I eat in a day. And believe it or not, my channel is called What Chelsea Eats, and I have never done a What I Eat in a Day video. I'm so glad you landed on my channel. My name is Chelsea Knutson, and I'm a certified holistic health coach, and I coach women on how to heal naturally from female-related issues using food as medicine. Be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you never miss an episode. First, we have this smoothie that is meant for two people. It makes about 72 ounces. It has 4 cups of unsweetened coconut milk, 3 large handfuls of spinach, 3 cups of frozen cherries, 1 cup of peaches, 2 fresh bananas. Also, 2 dropperfuls of liquid chlorophyll. The link will be in the description box below with the brand that I used. 1 dropperful of vanilla stevia, and that's it. And all I did for this recipe is blend it until smooth, and I shared it with my husband. And although this smoothie looks pretty disgusting, you see the ugly green color, it was absolutely delicious. Probably one of the best smoothies that I have ever eaten, or shall I say drank. So I just split it between me and my husband, and that kept me going for the entire morning. Also, if you're not using a Vitamix or you're using a smaller blender, please cut this recipe in half or to fit your blender, because this is a lot of smoothie. All of the recipes in this video will be below in the description box. Next, I'm going to share with you my lunch. Now for my lunch meal. I am making a lemon lentil soup. These are red lentils I'm putting in here. This is 1 cup of red lentils rinsed and drained. Adding 2 cups of carrots chopped. 1 cup celery chopped. Next, we're gonna add some black pepper to taste. That's probably about 1/8 of a teaspoon. Next is some coriander, 3/4 teaspoon. You can also use cilantro instead. Then we have 1 full teaspoon of cumin. Then we have 2 healthy vegetable bouillon cubes. The ones I use will be linked down below in the description box. And then we've got some cayenne. This is optional. You can do it to taste. If you like a little kick, then use the cayenne. If not, leave it out. And I've got 1 teaspoon of thyme. I love thyme in soups. It does wonders. And we're gonna add a little bit of fat to the soup just so it's more satiating. And I'm adding 1.5 tablespoons of almond butter, unsweetened and unsalted. And then we're gonna add the juice of 2 whole lemons. I think the lemon added to this soup is what made this soup. I really enjoyed it. Also, I'm thinking you probably could use limes for this. One day I'm going to make it and add limes instead of lemons and let you know how it turns out. Now we're going to add our water. I'm adding about 4 cups of water. And y'all know I'm using an instant pot. You can probably make this easily on top of the stove. You just have to adjust the cooking time based on how long it takes to cook lentils in either a crock pot or on top of the stove. And I am adding the lid onto my Instant Pot. So I cooked my lentils for 30 minutes. It's all done. Everything is nice and soft. I'm stirring everything together so that all the flavors meld together. It smells so good. Anyway, I'm going to add some fresh greens to this. I have spinach on hand, so I'm taking about, I think it's 4 packed cups of spinach that I'm using for this recipe. I'm just going to put all of them in there and stir them in there. You can use as many as you want, because what happens is as you stir the greens down into the hot soup, they sort of cook down a little bit. So I could have even added more for more nutrients. So now I'm just going to plate my soup. Oh, it looks so good. It really did taste good, y'all. You have to try this recipe. It's very light, it digests easily, and I just loved it. The other thing that was surprising about this soup is that it was creamy. I loved it. So you know we have to get in our salad every day, especially if you don't get enough greens in from your smoothie or your green juice. You've got to get these greens in, especially if you're trying to reverse iron deficiency or anemia or mineral deficiency in general. So I have washed and dried and chopped one head of romaine that I am dividing between two salads, one for me and one for Kenny. He's my husband. The goal for the day is to get in at least 1 pound of leafy greens a day. I know that sounds like a lot, but you need them for your minerals and so that you can stay satiated and so that you can kick cravings. Remember, the exact ingredients to these recipes are down in the description box. I've got a 6 ounce package of blueberries that I've split between the both two salads, and I have a half a cup of red onions chopped that I'm adding to the salad. And then I have about a half of an avocado that I've smashed up that I'm going to split between the two salads. And then we're going to add some tomatoes. I'm going to split a half a tomato between the two salads. Then I've got some chopped cucumber. I peeled these cucumbers because they weren't organic and they had that waxy film on each side. So be sure to peel your cucumbers if they're not organic, especially if they have the waxy buildup on the outside. Next, I'm going to add some crunch to the salad. I'm adding some pumpkin seeds, some raw pumpkin seeds. I love adding these to my salads, but you can choose whatever you want. Now it's time for seasonings. This is how I like to make my salads taste good. I love Benson's Table Tasty. I sprinkle it all over my salads and it gives them flavors. Benson's Table Tasty has a variety of different flavors. You can look down in the description box for the link for the ones that I like. And now for the salad dressing. This is a lemon basil vinaigrette. There's 2 tablespoons of balsamic vinegar, 1/2 cup of water, 1/4 cup of raw almonds, 1/4 cup of raisins, 1/3 cup of fresh basil, 1 teaspoon of Dijon mustard, and you can add salt to taste. I did not add salt, but this was creamy and it was very fragrant. It tasted really good too. When I make my salad dressings, the thing that I like to do is to make enough for a few salads. So I store them in glass mason jars and I pour it in there and then I screw on the lid, like a plastic lid, and I keep it stored in my refrigerator for 3 to 5 days. After that, for fresh salad dressing, you need to throw it away. So now y'all know what I typically eat in a day. This is different every day, but it usually has something to do with a smoothie, a juice, a soup, a salad, or some type of vegetable medley. That's usually what I eat, but I eat a variety of different foods sometimes, and then sometimes I eat the same thing over and over and over again. But if you would like some examples of what I eat, go back through my videos and watch the recipe videos if you want to know more about what I eat. You also can feel free to purchase my 7-day meal plan. It is linked down in the description box. I also have a juicing recipe ebook so you can see some of the recipes I use for my juices as well. I'm also coming out within the next 30 days or so with my Volume 2 7-day meal planner. So I'm excited about that. And the biggest thing is if we keep on eating clean and we eat foods that help our bodies to heal, we will feel better. We will start to eliminate those pesky symptoms and those fibroids will start to shrink. The endometriosis will start to heal. The ovarian cysts will shrink. You just have to keep plugging away and don't quit. No matter what you do, do not quit. But I'm so grateful that y'all tuned in to my video today. And if no one told you that they loved you today, Chelsea in North Carolina loves you very much. And I'll talk to you all soon. Take care.